putting your business in the street, talking out loud, saying you bought it this and that, how much you done spent. I swear she must believe it's all hell to see.
That's a worm. Yum.
Just a piece of roof flashing, lead flashing. I just cut it into a kind of an oval or a diamond shape, poke a hole in the top and the bottom, run my line through it, and then put on a treble hook. And it's just like a buzz bomb, it's a flutter jig. And I've caught everything on this. I've caught spring chinook on this.
Cool. Right now we're switching out.
Right now the tide's going at full speed, coming in, and when that happens, most of the fish are holding tight in the rocks. They don't come out as good, it's hard to get them. So we gotta wait for the tide to slow down, and usually about half hour before slack tide, you start catching some fish. Then right at slack tide, if we can catch some fish, we'll put one on the hook and we'll send it down in the deeper water over there,
right over there,
where there's a big rock ledge. See if we can pull a ling cod out of there. Right now it's just way too fast, so if we get anything in the next hour, that'd be kind of lucky. But I already did have one bite, but it's hard to get them when it's this fast. But we're not skunked. We're about skunked right in the mouth. It took like 3 seconds.
Gorgeous fish.
This vaccine's first fish of the day. Didn't get skunked, did we?
We're throwing him back.
A little small anyway. Oh, greenling.
Ooh, look at that. That's just what we need to catch a giant ling cod. Cool, Eli.
Cut the line so I don't kill him. I have to go way down in it.
decent. That's a decent one. We got something to eat, so we can eat that one.
Beautiful.
Oops.
Yeah, because they generally cut your line off right about there. That if you get a really big ling cod, they got giant teeth. They get stuck in the rocks. Your line rubs back and forth on their teeth until it cuts.
So metal.
One of those classic blue lings.
Wow, it's so blue. It's
He'll go 24.
Meat.
Blue ling. He's going to have blue meat. Look at his meat. His meat is going to be as blue as his tongue.
Wow. Hey, there's a finger in there.
Is that your first ling cod?
Yeah.
Down here in Oregon? You caught him in Alaska, right?
Yeah.
But that's probably your first blue.
Yep, for sure.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Taught her how to talk like that. I wonder, 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 wonder. Give that big idea. Nothing you can't handle, nothing you ain't got. Put your money on the table and drive it off the lot. Turn on that old love light. Turn a baby to a yes. Same old schoolboy game got you into this mess. Hey, son, better get on back to town. Face the sad old truth, the dirty law down.
I wonder, 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 wonder.
Put those ideas in your head. Have a Jones for this, Jones for that. This running with the Joneses, boy, just ain't where it's at. You're gonna come back around to the sad, sad truth, the dirty law down.
The big ones, aren't you? Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm not even gonna measure that one.
There's some biggies in there.
Or this one.
Look at that.
Nice and hard too. Not that I care. Wowzer, I think we're done crabbing for the day, even if we run out of
bait. Oh my God.
Thank you.
Yeah, there you go. There's a blue meat.
Yeah, I see we got about, probably about 7 pounds right here. And we don't even have the collars in there or nothing yet, so probably got 8 or 10 pounds of meat today.
Yeah, spray all that dirt, all this hairy stuff right here. It's all kind of mud and dirt in there. Makes your water all yucky and brown and green and yucky. This is a big one. That's a big one.
Well, that's pretty good catch of crab, that's for sure.
Shellfish preparation. Takes a while. This is actually kind of a garlic dish. So, garlic is required. Alright. That's that. We've got two more ingredients to chop and then we're ready. Because it's colorful. I don't know how hot they are. Andy grew them, so.
I bet they're hot as hell.
That's enough for this whole dish right there.
Time. This actually, it will be good. Time and seafood go together well.
Yeah, they do.
Enough to basically, lightly saute our onions. We're not trying to caramelize them here. We're just gonna get, just a little past translucent. That's the first thing every time, right there.
Yeah, tell us about all the other ingredients.
Okay, so then after that, we're gonna put in a little celery and garlic, some spice like thyme and hot peppers, just a little bit. But basically this is kind of a tomato wine seafood soup. So a large portion is going to be our tomato and the largest portion is going to be seafood as well.
You got
lingcod. We have lingcod, yeah. We got shrimp that we had to buy because, well, we don't go shrimping very often. We got mussels off the jetty today. And then we got a bunch of crab, and we'll throw some crab in there.
Oh,
in the
end. Maybe get some crab out.
Now we're going to toss in a good handful of garlic. We're going to let those go for just a couple minutes. And then we're going to add one of the main ingredients, which is white wine. I've got about a half a quart there. So this is a very important part of the dish. And at this point, we're going to let this simmer for about 5 minutes to boil the alcohol off. Then we'll bring in our tomatoes, fresh chopped tomatoes, and tomato puree or sauce or however. I kind of did a little combination of both, but that'll be. And once that happens, then we'll let it simmer for about 20 minutes before we start adding the ingredients.
Okay.
It's okay to steal a claw. Hey, it's got no claws.
Ready? I'm going in. Well, that looks really good, kids. Oh, yeah.
Crispity crunchity. I love it. All right. So
yeah. I don't smell too much alcohol coming. So we got a little bit of thyme. We got a little bit of fresh red jalapeno out of
Anderson's garden. We might as well just throw those in there. And we've got our fresh garden tomatoes. I didn't de-seed them, but I did skin them. I don't care about seeds. And we got our tomato puree. And no fresh cracked black today, so we're gonna have to make do with regular old black pepper. And that'll go probably, we need to go about 20 minutes and let that all do its thing. And then we're gonna throw in a bunch of fresh, raw, and semi-cooked stuff, and it's all gonna come together, hopefully. All right. So we had that on a simmer for about 25 minutes or so. Now we're gonna bring it up to pretty good heat, and we're gonna start adding in some cold ingredients, so that's gonna drop the heat on everything. We're gonna try, I think we drop our lean cod. I got in what, 3/4, half inch cubes or whatever. Drop that in there. I think we can do the crab next too, because it's kind of been on ice, so it needs to warm up. I kind of overcooked them yesterday, so there's not much possibility of me overcooking them again. We'll let that come up to a good boil. Then we'll add in our shrimp. And last, we'll add the mussels. And that will be the last of the proteins that we add. Yeah, fish like this really takes maybe 30 seconds to cook in boiling water or boiling juice. So I'm gonna toss in some fresh shrimp. And this is a required must. It's mussels. They're not my favorite exactly, but I know what kind of flavor they create, and you gotta have them to make Cioppino. Soon as the mussels open up, you put the lid on, you close it, you let it rest for a little bit, and you're ready to eat.
All right.
And let it cool for about 15 minutes. Because it's gonna scald our faces if we eat it now.
Oh no, we have to wait.
I know, huh?
We suck at waiting.
I'm gonna lay in like, what? Side of crab over here.
Yeah.
Maybe a claw over here. You won't see it in a minute. And there is some shrimp and some ling cod in that broth right there. It's all about the broth, baby. Then you gotta stir them around a little bit and figure out which mussel looks best for you.
Oh yeah, that was good.
Mm-hmm. Then for you, I will finish it with a little chiffonade of basil.
Basil.
And a little bit of chives.
Right.
And you need to wait a few minutes before you eat that, because it's going to burn your face.
Let's try it. Looks good.
Yeah, we did a little crust.
Oh, yeah. These, I think I would, next time I'll use smaller mussels, though.
Yeah.
I did get small ones, but I thought the size, well, if I had a bigger plate, it wouldn't matter, but this is kind of crowding the plate with mussels. But hey, what do you do? Put some chopped jalapenos on there.
He's going hot.
I like it hot and spicy. There's no real rule to this meal. There's no real rule at all. I suppose if you use X amount of Mexican spices. Oh, baby. Oh, now we gotta cut up some bread. Let's just move these herbs aside. That we find.
Oh yeah, that works. It's kind of a rule that you have to use mussels, you have to use wine, you have to use tomato sauce, and you have to use some sort of crusty, good crustini of some sort, or something to soak up the sauce. It's just something to soak up the sauce. Oh my goodness. It's very seafoody.
Tastes like life.
Mm-hmm. Tastes like life from the sea.
Okay, I gotta quit filming and
wowzer.
Get in there. Oh my god.
Whenever I wanna see heaven, I'll just go look for my spoon. Now I get to eat some fish and shrimp too. That's different. Happy
birthday. Oh my god. OMG. This is one of the best things we've ever made. Yeah, for sure. What do you think, Eli? Think it's one of the best things we've ever made?
I think we fared well. It's pretty, it's very seafoody.